Big weekend in Liga MX. Club America beating Chivas 1-0 on aggregate. Cruz Azul advancing past Rayados on the tiebreaker, which we will remind you is, of course, their position in the table throughout the regular season, which means we've got a Club America Cruz Azul final. First leg Thursday at Cruz Azul. The second leg Sunday at the famed Estadio Azteca. Let's dive into each of the semifinals. We'll start with the Clásico Nacional, América against Chivas. And the first question here for you, Herc, is should América's goal, which was scored in the 60th minute by Israel Reyes, have been disallowed? And I want to remind everybody, nobody on the production team is a Chivas fan, just in case you were wondering if that had anything to do.
Listen, the amount of expert analysis I see out there claiming this to be a foul is shocking and embarrassing. In no point in time can you judge a VAR type of play video by a still shot or in slow motion. This is literally the Chivas player Orozco crashing into Lichnowsky and nothing else. Lichnowsky establishes position, establishes his space, and it's the Chivas player that comes into him. But when you take a picture and you see Lichnowsky's hand, arm above Orozco, it makes it look like it's a foul and you're trying to pass judgment on a still shot. It is embarrassing. In no way, shape, or form is this ever a foul anywhere in the world. The man got out jumped, and in the second play, Israel Reyes out jumps two more players of Chivas in that sequence. This ain't it. If we're trying to pick something, this is not it. The amount, I repeat, of expert analysis on this is shocking to me. It's quite embarrassing, if you will.
Wow, look at that. That is from Herc. That's not from Seb. Look, I mean, the freeze frame is pretty damning, right? He's got his arm around him. I could see why you might think it was a foul, but it wasn't called. And if we're going to go down the should've, could've, would've route, which seems to be what we always do with America, let's talk about all the red cards that Chivas should have had in the first leg, in the second leg, should have finished the first leg with 10, probably should have finished the second leg with 9, if we're being honest. So, and then beyond that, we can acknowledge that even if America's goal had been disallowed, Herc, would Chivas have advanced?
Oh, time out. This is where I disagree with you, and this is where I disagree with a lot of people. People keep bringing that up, like a tie works for Chivas. Do you know what happens if this game is 0-0, heading 80 minutes in? You know what kind of pressure America's under? You know what kind of pressure America's under?
What kind of pressure would Chivas under to score? They had 30 minutes after this goal to score two goals. Did they score one?
Seb,
couldn't get the job half done.
Seb,
please.
That's not how it
this
works.
Is about Chivas,
that's not
how it not works.
When
America.
You chase the game, you got to take unnecessary chances, and everything is different in the complexion of this game, this condition. That's not how football
America
works.
Were closer to scoring a second than Chivas a first.
That's fine, Seb. That's fine. After they scored. Do not forget that Chivas.
So Chivas was just going to sit back. They still had the
Hold
need
on.
To go get a goal.
Let me talk. Do not forget that Chivas, to start off this game, was a more dangerous team out of the two. Do not forget they were the better team in the first half. Do not forget Piojo Alvarado hitting the crossbar. Do not forget.
The almost. Almost happened.
Hold
that
on.
Almost.
You're bringing up hypotheticals. This is your alley, not mine. You're the one going into hypotheticals. I'm trying to tell you that goals change games. The moment this goal is scored, it conditions Chivas to be a different team going forward, which exposes them in the back. Now, I agree with you. Never a foul. I agree with you. Second half, there was one team. But if you think about
second
this for
half,
a second.
When Chivas needed a goal, there was one team.
Listen, Seb.
Perfecto.
Listen.
Thank you.
Listen. Se murieron de nada. This is what upsets me about Chivas. America won with so little. This wasn't a convincing performance by America by any means, but they won, and that's all you need to do. But Chivas, when you really needed something, when you really needed to attack the goal, you couldn't muster up any crosses, you couldn't muster up shots, you couldn't muster anything in the final third. That is my only criticism of Chivas. It's not the refereeing, it's not the individual talent. If you're gonna go down swinging. They did not go down swinging for a team that I think is a little bit more limited when it comes to resources at their disposal. They should have thrown everything they had at America, and they didn't.
You use the word to describe America, that they were not convincing. Just how unconvincing have they been throughout this Liga run as they arrived to the final?
That's unfair. That is unfair. And I take issue with the question. I really do. Because this is one of the most poor Liguillas that I've seen in recent memory. I can't think of a more underwhelming Liguilla than this one. And I could sit here and say, yeah, Club America didn't look good against Pachuca, they didn't look good against Chivas, But I could pick a moment in time for every single team that's participated in this Liguilla and say, they didn't look good there. Look at Cruz Azul, who's in the final. You know, very well against Unam, Pumas, you know, in Seoul, and then at home, wow, very shaky. Where's this Cruz Azul team? Very good against Rayados and beat them, you know, in Monterrey. And then, wow, very shaky. Well, you know, same thing with America. Same thing with Chivas. Every single team that's participated in this tournament, participating in this Liguilla, has been underwhelming at some point in time. America did what they needed to do. America needed to tie, to draw, or win, to advance. They did that. America is still the team that's played the best this calendar year. I'm not even going to stick to this season. This calendar year, they've been the best proponent of actual football that I have seen. So I take issue with the question, because this convincing thing that we seem to throw around doesn't sit well when the whole Liguilla isn't
convincing. The bar's higher for America. That's what I think the thing is when you say convincing. The bar for America to be convincing is higher than everybody else. But Herc,
do you care?
I don't think there's a single Club America fan out there that would tell you they're convinced by this America team.
Hold on. Do you care if it's a miracle against Pachuca? You just care that you advanced, right?
Hey, all I heard was Papachuca advanced past
them.
All I heard was Chivas had won six in a row.
You celebrated a draw like it was a World Cup win. Do you care that it was a draw? No, you care that you advanced, correct?
That's all that matters. That's all that matters in Liguilla. But I will say this. You're not wrong. You're not wrong that the Liguilla has been underwhelming. And if